This lesson is entitled Global Economy. Learning objectives: at the end of the lesson, you should be able to define economic globalization, explain the role of the international financial institutions, and discuss the different types of economic system. Okay, let us define economic globalization. It is the free movement of goods, capital, services, technology, and information. So it refers to the increasing interdependence of world economies as a result of the growing scale of cross-border trade of commodities and services, flow ng international capital, and wide and rapid spread of technologies. Okay, na-mention dito yung word or term na interdependence. Okay, what do you mean by interdependence? When we say interdependence, it refers to the two or more countries that impact or rely on each other. So may mutual dependency. Okay? So while globalization, yung term na globalization, it is the economic, social, and political interaction and integration of people in different areas of the world. So nowadays, most nations are becoming more independent and related in a globalized world. Okay? So, since we are dealing with the global economy, may ginagampanan ang mga international financial institutions or IFI. Okay? So, when we say international financial institutions, meron siyang major role na ginagampanan in the social and economic development programs of nations with developing or transitional economies. Particularly, ito yung mga developing countries. So, tinutulungan ng international financial institutions, particularly itong mga developing countries. So, this role of the international financial institutions includes advising on development projects, funding them, and assisting in their implementation. So it is characterized by AAA credit rating or ratings, okay? In a broad membership of borrowing and donor countries. So each of these institutions operates independently. Sir, ano yung AAA credit rating? Pag sinabi natin AAA credit rating, yung AAA, yung AAA credit ratings denote the lowest expectation of default risk. Okay? So they are assigned only in cases of exceptionally strong capacity for payment of financial commitments. Okay? Pag sinabi natin ano yung lowest default risk, meaning yung isang bansa, it has the lowest chance of failure to fulfill an obligation, especially to repay a loan or debt. Okay? Ibig sabihin, meron siyang capacity to pay. Kapag nangutang yung isang bansa, meron siyang capacity to pay or repay the loan. Okay? So, it is the highest possible credit rating a prospective borrower can have, itong AAA rating. So yung AAA score is awarded by a credit ratings agency. So however share the following goals and objectives. Ano bang objectives ng international financial institutions? Okay, to reduce the global poverty, yung kahirapan, mabigyan ng solution ng kahirapan ng mga bawat bansa, and improve people's living conditions and standard. Okay, ano pa yung goals and objectives ng IFI? To support sustainable economic, social, and institutional development, and to promote also the regional cooperation and integration. Okay? So ito yung mga examples of IFI. Like, for example, itong International Monetary Fund or IMF. And then yung Multilateral Development Banks or MDBs, which include yung mga World Bank, African Development Bank, Asian Development Bank, Inter-American Development Bank, and European Bank for Reconstruction and Development. So yung letter B hanggang letter E, ito yung mga Regional Development Banks o RDB. Okay? So yung mga institutional or international financial institutions achieve these objectives sa pamamagitan ng pagpapautang or credit and grants to national governments. Such funding is usually tied to specific projects na naka-focus on economic and socially sustainable development. Okay, yung mga international financial institutions also nagpo-provide din sila ng mga technical and advisory assistance to their borrowers. Okay, and nagka-conduct din sila ng extensive research on development issues. Like for example, the Philippines. Okay? The Philippines increased spending on construction ng mga roads, mga bridges, ng mga air and sea ports, and other large-scale projects in recent years. Diba? So itong mga public infrastructure investment increased from an average of 3% of gross domestic product during 2011 hanggang 2016 to over 5% in 2018, diba? With the target of raising the ratio to over 6% by 2022. So yung project ng government natin, yung program ng Build program ng Duterte administration, includes large projects that address major problems focusing on transportation, water resources, and energy. So dito nilalaan yung inutang ng Pilipinas, okay, sa mga international financial institutions. And kapag when completed, these projects are expected to bring important benefits to the Philippine economy. And syempre, to the lives of ordinary citizens. So para magkaroon tayo ng better transportation and internet services, and for example, would help farmers, para makatulong din sa mga Filipino farmers, bring their produce such as bananas, mga mangoes to the market. At para mapataas yung income ng mga rural population. Okay? So more generally, improvements in the quality of infrastructure services will help cut the cost of doing business. Okay? Nag-a-attract siya ng more investment and enhance productivity around the Philippines or around the country. Okay? Another example, the World Bank Board of Executive Directors, in-approve nila yung sabihin natin $500 million na loan ng Philippines to help the Philippines mitigate the impact of COVID-19 pandemic on poor and vulnerable households. Kasi sila talaga yung tinamaan ng COVID-19 pandemic. And to provide financial relief to small and medium enterprises. So yung mga mahihirap na Pilipino ang tinamaan sa kayong mga small and medium enterprises o mga negosyante. Yung iba kasi sa kanila nag-declared na ng bankruptcy, okay, because of COVID-19 pandemic. Okay? So again, malaki ang naitutulong ng mga international financial institutions. Lalo ngayon, may COVID-19 pandemic. So malaki ang naitutulong ng loan para sa government response laban dito sa COVID-19 pandemic. Okay? So, meron tayong tinatawag na income class system bracket in the Philippines. Since I have mentioned the yung terms na may mga small and medium enterprises, yung mga tinamaan ng COVID-19 pandemic, usually ito yung mga mahihirap na kababayan natin, o mga poor families. So, karamihan sa mga government projects naka-focus sa kanila. Kasi sila talaga yung tinamaan ng problema dito sa COVID-19 pandemic. So, bakit kailangan nating magkaroon ng social classes? Bakit natin kailangan i-simplify yung income class system? Okay? Para magkaroon natin o ma-identify natin, ma-identify yung mga beneficiaries of various government programs, especially during COVID-19 pandemic. Yan yung sinabi ni Angara. So, kailangan alamin natin kung sino yung tutulungan natin at sino yung mga tinamaan ng COVID-19 pandemic. Particularly, for example, yung mga poor families. Paano natin malalaman kapag poor family sila? Kapag they earn below 10,957 pesos monthly income. So sila yung may income na below 10,000 pesos and 957. Kapag low income naman but not poor, kumikita sila ng or they earn 10,957 to 21,000 pesos and 914. Ito yung monthly income nila. Yung mga lower middle naman na family, they earn 21,914 pesos to 43,828. So, ito yung monthly income nila. Kapag middle family naman, they earn 43,828 hanggang 76,660 monthly income yun. Kapag upper middle naman ng bawat pamilya, so yung pamilya ay kumikita ng 76,669 to 131,484. Okay, monthly income. And then yung upper middle but not rich, meron silang monthly income na 131,483 to 219,140. And then yung mga mayayamang pamilya, ito yung classification nila. Kumikita sila ng 219,140 and above monthly. Okay? So ito yung income nila monthly. So again, kailangan natin ma-identify kung sino yung tutulungan ng gobyerno. Diyan magpo-focus yung mga government projects. Okay? To help them during COVID-19 pandemic. Lalo maraming nagsarado na kumpanya and most of them umaasa lang sa employment nila. So sila talaga yung tinamaan nung pandemic. Okay? Sila yung mga nawalan ng trabaho. Okay? Next, economic system. Ano ibig sabihin ng economic system? So, an economic system or economic order is a system of production, resource allocation, and distribution of goods and services within a society or given geographic area. It includes the combination of the various institutions, agencies, entities, and decision-making processes and patterns of consumption that comprise the economic structure of a given community. An economic system is a type of social system. The mode of production is a related concept. So all economic systems must confront and solve the four fundamental economic problems. So ano yung four fundamental economic problems or questions? What kinds and quantities of goods shall be produced? How goods shall be produced? How the output will be distributed? And then when to produce? So bakit kaya kailangan na sagutin itong four fundamental economic problems? So again, why is it important to solve these four fundamental economic problems? Because the economic system is a means by which societies or governments organize and distribute available resources, ano pa, services and goods across a geographic region or country. Okay? May mga economic system tayong tinatawag. Traditional, command, market economic system, and then mixed economic system. Okay, discuss muna natin yung traditional economic system. Pag sinabi natin traditional economic system, this system is the most traditional and ancient types of economies in the world. Okay? Karamihan ito yung mga second or third world countries o karamihan sa mga areas rural. Okay? So, in general, anong characteristic ng traditional economic system? They do lack access to technology and advanced medicine. So, yan ang kinakaharap na problema ng traditional economic system. Okay. So, yung traditional economic system, nagre-rely siya on customs, history, and time beliefs. Okay? So, yung tradition guides economic decisions such as production and distribution. Traditional economies depend on agriculture, fishing, hunting, gathering, or some combination of the above. Okay? Ito ngayon, yung mga fishing, hunting, and gathering of food. Okay? They use barter system. Alam mo yung palitan ng kalakalan. Ito yung barter system instead of using money. Okay? Next, explain pa natin itong traditional economic system. Pag sabi natin traditional economic system din, it may be based on, again, custom and tradition. Okay? With economic decision based on customs or beliefs of the community, family, clan, or tribe. Okay? So, yung mga countries that use this type of economic system, itong traditional economic system, are often rural and farm-based. Okay? Yung mga traditional economies are popularly conceived of as a primitive or undeveloped economic systems. So, hindi pa developed yung economy nila. And then having outdated tools or techniques na ginagamit. So, hindi na updated yung techniques o yung mga tools na ginagamit nila sa pagpoproduce ng mga resources, ng mga goods. Okay? Like for example, bigay tayo maganda example. In some rural areas sa Pilipinas, di ba, yung mga farmers mainly use karabaw, di ba, and some traditional tools like bolo for plowing and water din as primary requirements to start planting. So yan ang ginagamit nila sa pagtatanim. Okay, yung bolo saka yung karabaw. So medyo outdated na yung tools or yung technique na ginagamit dito sa traditional economic system. Okay? Bigay pa tayo ng example. Sa traditional economy din, for example, yung mga children who are raised on farms, di ba, are likely to be farmers din. Pag tumanda sila, farmers na rin sila. Yung mga mangingisda, tinuturuan din nila yung mga anak nila para mangisda. Kaya paglaki ng mga anak nila, ang occupation din ng mga anak nila, pagtanda, mangingisda din. Okay? Rather than using money, instead of gumamit sila ng pera or paper bill, they will exchange the goods they produce. Like for example, kung nagpo-produce sila ng milk or bigas, for goods, tinetrade nila yon sa mga goods na kailangan nila. Like, for example, palitan sila ng kalakalan. Okay, papalit nila yung milk or yung rice, papalit ng eggs and vegetables for food. Okay, so ito yung tinatawag na barter system. Nagpapalitan lang sila ng goods. Hindi sila gumagamit ng money. Okay, next. Command economic system. In command economic system, yung large part of the economic system is controlled by the government. Okay? So the government determines what to produce. Anong kailangan i-produce na resources or goods na kailangan ng mga Pilipino or na kailangan ng mga citizens? Paano ito ipoproduce? sila rin ang magde-determine ng presyo o magre-regulate ng mga prices ng mga goods and services. So ibig sabihin sa command economic system, kontrolado lahat ng mga basic services ng gobyerno. Okay? So the command economy is capable of creating a healthy supply of its resources and it rewards its people with affordable prices. So yung government usually owns all the critical industries like yung mga utilities, yung supply ng tubig, supply ng kuryente, aviation, saka yung mga railroad, ito yung mga transportation. So sila ang nagko-control niyan, gobyerno. So sila ang nagmamay-ari ng mga sabihin natin mga industries na nagde-deliver ng mga basic services. So kontrolado ng government yan. Lahat ng utilities, aviation and railroad and other basic needs ng tao. Okay? Pag sinabi natin, again, pag sinabi natin yung command economic system, itong it is a type of economic system in which yung government siya ang nagpa-plan, nag-organize at nagko-control of all economic activities to maximize social welfare. Okay? Like for example, bigay pa tayo ng maganda example. The government regulates goods and services produced in the country. So again, sila nagre-regulate ng mga goods and services. Itong government natin. Okay? So kapag command economic system yon. Okay, next. Kung meron tayong tinatawag na command economic system, kontrolado ng government lahat ng mga industries na nagsusupply ng mga basic needs ng tao like utilities, aviation, and transportation, sa market economic system naman or tinatawag na free market economy, yung mga firms and households act in self-interest to determine how resources get allocated, what goods get produced, and who buys the goods. Okay? In this type of economy, there is a separation between the government and the market. Okay? This separation prevents the government from becoming too powerful and keeps their interest aligned with that of the markets. Okay, bigay tayo magkanta example ng free market economy. Hong Kong is considered as an example of free market society. Okay? Paano pa natin i-characterize ang free market? Meron siyang free cooperative and peaceful process, free to choose your work, free to be an investor. Kung may pera ka, mamuhunan ka. Kung may capital ka, financial capital ka, magnegosyo ka kung gusto mo. Walang pipigil sa'yo. Okay, ito yung mga kapitalista. Free to be an entrepreneur. Free to create capital formation, free to earn profits. So sa free market, profit motives ang mga kapitalista or capitalist kasi gusto nilang kumita. Okay? Free to compete. Kahit sampu kayong naglalaban sa market, kahit sampu kayong seller ng computer, okay, marami kayong nagko-compete pagdating sa telecommunication. So kahit walang pipigil sa inyo. Okay? So kahit ilan pa yung competitors or sabihin natin yung mga telecommunication companies, hindi pipigilan yan ng government. Okay? Kasi free market yan. Malaya kayo, okay, na magnegosyo. And then free to buy, own, use, and sell private property. And then free to set prices. So sila nagdi-dictate ng mga prices. Ito mga private companies. So kabaliktaran ng command economic system. Kung yung command economic system, lahat ng mga firms ay kontrolado ng government, dito sa market economic system o free market, kontrolado naman yan ng mga private companies. Okay? Kung may pera ka, magnegosyo ka. So, pwede ka maging entrepreneur or investor. Okay? So, Sa free market, again, it is an economic system based on supply and demand with little or no government control. Okay? So, there's no government control in free market economy. Kung meron man government control, sabi natin a little lang. Hindi ganun kahigpit yung government natin. Okay? In a free market, yung mga companies and resources are owned again by private individuals or entities who are free to trade contracts with each other. Okay? So again, ang nagmamay-ari niyan, mga private individuals. Okay, in a free or pure market economy, yung mga sellers of different goods, again, do not face any barriers. Ano ba yung barriers? Ito yung tariff, ito yung quota, ito yung diniscuss natin sa lesson number one, di ba? Yung tariff saka yung quota. So sa free market economy, again, yung mga sellers of different goods, they do not face any barriers. Malaya sila. Pero essentially, one can sell any product they wish to sell in the market at any price. Pero however, kasi ano eh, in the real world, such an economic system rarely exists. Kasi meron at meron pa rin tariffs eh. Ito yung sinasabi ko kanina na sa free market economy, yung supply and demand ay walang government control. Okay? Pero kahit pa paano meron din eh. In real world, meron at meron pa rin eh, na makikialam ang government. Okay? Bigay tayo magandang example. Kahit na sa free market economy at kontrolado yan ng mga private individuals o mga private companies, meron pa rin kasing government regulation. Okay? Like for example, na hindi naman ganun kahigpit ang government natin dito sa free market economy. Example, halimbawa na lang, yung tariff imposed on imports and exports. Diba? And then may mga legal restrictions din, such as the age restriction on alcoholic beverages. These are some barriers to a free market economy. Diba? Halimbawa, kapag below 18 years old, they are prohibited to buy an alcoholic beverage. So hindi sila pwede bumili ng beer. Diba? Pinagbabawalan yung mga below 18 years of age. So meron pa rin ng regulation ng government. Okay? Particularly yung age restriction na in-impose na policy ng government. So kahit papaano, merong little participation ang government sa free market or talagang no government control. Okay? Next, sa mixed economic system, ikinombine. Ikinombine ang command and free market. Okay? So this economic system is a cross again between market economy and command economy. In the most common types of mixed economies, the market is more or less free of government ownership. Pero except for a few key areas like transportation or sensitive industries like defense and railroad. So ano ba karakteristik ng mixed economic system? Yung mga empleyado or laborers are being protected by the government. So nag-impose ng mga labor rights. Di ba? Safeguarding of consumer rights. So hindi pwede yung, again, hindi pwede yung no return policy. Bawal yon. So pinoprotektahan pa rin ng government yung mga consumers. So dito sa mixed economic system, may mga ilan pagmamay-ari ng private companies, may mga ilan naman pagmamay-ari ng government. Kaya mixed. Okay? So again, owned by private sectors sa market economy. Pagdating naman sa command, owned by the government. And then sa market economy, freedom to start business. Sa command economy naman, may mga government regulations. Kinokontrol pa rin ng government. Okay, malaya kayo mag-business, yun nga lang, merong government regulation. And then, sa market economy, sila ang yung mga sellers ang nagde-determine ng supply and demand. Okay? So, example, kapag mataas ang demand, magtataas sila ng supply. Kapag mababa ang demand sa produktong iyan, kukunti lang yung isusupply nila sa market. Okay, sa command economy naman, ang magdi-dictate ng price, government. So, kinombine ang market economy at command economy. So, ulitin natin, may mga ilang industries or companies ang nagmamay-ari, private or private individuals. At may mga ilang kumpanya naman ang nagmamay-ari, government. Okay? So, again, ang mixed economic system, kinocombine ang capitalism at socialism. So, ano yung socialism? Again, pag sabi natin socialism, ito yung public ownership or public control of property and natural resources. So, public ang nagmamay-ari niyan. Okay? Yung mixed economic system protects private property and allows a level of economic freedom. So, in the use of capital, but also allows yung government din to interfere in economic activities in order to achieve social aims. Sir, ang Philippines, paano natin i-describe ang Philippine economic system? So, ang Philippines has a mixed economic system that includes a variety of private freedom combined with centralized economic planning and government regulations. So, ang Philippines ay mixed economic system. Okay, next. Sir, ano yung McDonald's decision? Parang ito yung fast food. Okay, McDonald's. Okay, McDonald's decision. So, according kay George Reed, sir, siya ang nag-introduce ng concept ng McDonaldization with his book in 1993, The McDonaldization of Society. The basic idea is that these elements have been adapted based on the characteristics of a fast food restaurant. So yung efficiency, calculability, predictability, and standardization and control. And that this adaptation has rifle effects throughout all aspects of society. Okay, so ano ibig sabihin ng efficiency, calculability, predictability, and standardization and control? Okay, pag sabi natin efficiency, ano ba ibig sabihin ng efficiency? It entails a managerial focus on minimizing the time required to complete the individual task, as well as the required to complete the whole operation or process of production and distribution. So, paano ka makakapag-produce ng output in a minimal time? So, napakabilis mag-produce ng output. Okay? So, yun ang efficiency. So, again, minimizing the time required to complete the individual task. So nakita niyo yung sa McDonald's, di ba? Yung pagsiserve ng pagkain mabilis, kaya nga fast food. So nakita yung efficiency. Next, calculability. Ano ibig sabihin nun? It is a focus on quantifiable objectives. Ito yung counting things, pagbibilang ng bagay, rather than subjective ones o yung pag-evaluate ng quality. So mas importante yung counting things rather than yung evaluation of quality. Okay? So, naka-focus siya sa quantifiable objectives. Okay? Pagbibilang ng output. Ilan ba ang kailangan natin i-produce na products? Okay? Lalo kapag nagbig sa ano yung mga customers, hindi pwedeng mabagal. Kailangan marami tayong ma-produce na outputs. Okay? Next. predictability and standardization. These are found in na merong repetition and routine. So nakita niyo sa fast food na McDonald's, merong paulit-ulit silang ginagawa, naging sistema na nila yon. Lalo kapag sa kitchen, saka sa pagsuserve ng pagkain, so routine na. Alam na nila yung ginagawa nila. So may repetition saka routinized production or service delivery processes. So very consistent yung output nila, output ng product nila. Or kasi nakabase yan sa customer satisfaction experience. Okay? So hindi nila binabago yung quality. Ang basis kasi nila, yung customer satisfaction survey. Okay? Next, yung control naman, yung control within McDonaldization by the management to ensure that the workers appear and act the same on moment to moment and daily basis. So it refers to the use of robots and technology to reduce or replace human employees wherever possible. Okay? So hindi nyo napansin sa McDonald's or other fast food chains, minsan gumagamit na rin o madalas gumagamit na sila ng technology. Lalo kapag o-order ka ng pagkain. Diba? Meron doon machine. O-order ka na lang, i-click mo kung ano yung order mo. Okay? And then may mga combination. So, i-click mo lang yung order mo, pupunta ka na sa counter. So, ganun kabilis. Okay? So, ang tawag dyan ay McDonaldization. So, sabi dito, lahat ng mga organizations, institutions, yung mga agencies, mainam daw na gamitin ang konsepto na ito na tinatawag na McDonaldization. Okay? Next, state of market. Okay, meron tayong tinatawag na shortage, surplus, and equilibrium. Okay? Pagsabing shortage, when the quantity demanded of a good or service or resource is greater than the quantity supplied. Pag surplus, when the quantity supplied of good of a good or service or resource is greater than the quantity demanded. Pag equilibrium, nangyayari yan when price has adjusted until quantity supplied is equal to the quantity demanded. Okay? So again, yung shortage, condition yan where the quantity demanded is greater than the quantity supplied at the market price. Yung surplus, ito naman yung excess supply. Sobra yung supply nila. Okay? Pag sinabi natin equilibrium, walang shortage, wala ring surplus. So the quantity of the good that buyers are willing to buy equals to the quantity that sellers are willing to sell. Kaya equilibrium. Okay? So bigay tayo ng example. By the way, ano yung formula ng state of market? So yung QS stands for quantity supply. Yung QD stands for quantity demand. So again, yung quantity demand, ibig sabihin ng demand, ito yung willingness ng mga consumers to buy the goods or services. Ito yung kagustuhan ng mga buyers na bilhin yung product na yon. And then yung supply naman, ito yung quantity ng goods and services na ilalabas ng mga producers ng mga goods and services. Kung gaano kadami yung ilalabas nila sa market. Okay? Example, 800 yung quantity demand. Ang nangangailangan niyan, 800. 800 people ang nangangailangan. Kaso ang supply mo, 1,000. So, QS minus QD or quantity supply minus quantity demand equals to 200. So, sumobra. Kasi 800 lang yung nangangailangan, 800 lang yung demand. Eh yung supply mo, 1,000 o 1,000 pieces. 1,000 bottles, for example, so sumobra ng 200. Therefore, kapag positive, surplus. Mas marami yung supply kaysa sa demand. Okay? Solve natin to letter B. Yung quantity demand, 1,600. Okay? Pero yung supply, 1,500. So, 1,600 minus 1,500, so may shortage na 100. Negative 100. Okay? Negative. Kinapos ng 100 kasi 1,600 yung nangangailangan. Kaso ang supply ng sa market, 1,500 lang. So, merong shortage na 100. Okay? Like for example, ano yung mga nagkaroon ng shortage during pandemic? Yung face mask, saka yung face shield. Ang dami nangangailangan pero kulang ng supply. So naalala nyo, nung nagsimula yung COVID-19 pandemic, nagkaroon na maraming shortage ng alcohol face mask. Okay? And next, sa letter C tayo. Yung quantity demand, 3,200. Pero ang supply, 2,000. So ilan ang kulang? So may kulang na. So 3,200 minus 2,000, may kulang na 1,200. So may shortage. Okay? Next, pareho lang. 300 yung nangangailangan, 300 din yung supply. So equilibrium. Next, 4,200 yung quantity demand. Eh ang supply, 4,500. So merong sobra na 300. So this is surplus. Ang state of market, merong surplus na 300. Okay, may sobra. Okay, so maraming bagay na surplus. Like for example, sa mga ukay-ukay, maraming mga damit na hindi naman nabebenta. So, kokonti ang demand, pero napakadaming supply. So, example niyan, mga damit sa mga ukay-ukay na minsan buy one, take one lang, pinapaubos na nila. Okay, so, pag ibig sabihin ng surplus, mas marami yung supply or the quantity supply is greater than the quantity demand or demanded. Pag shortage, yung quantity demanded of goods or services or resources ay greater than the quantity supplied. And then kapag equilibrium, walang shortage, wala rin surplus. Okay, next. Okay, the point of maximum profit. May tinatawag tayong revenue. Pag sabing revenue, parang ito yung kinita ng kumpanya o ng firm. Revenue is the money generated from normal business operations calculated as the average sales price times the number of units sold. Okay? Ito yung formula or indicator. Revenue, ang formula ng revenue, paano pag-compute ng revenue? Quantity supply times the price per unit. Or letter P. And then yung state of market naman, total revenue minus total cost. So ano yung total cost? Ito yung nagastos ng firm sa pagpo-produce ng goods or services. Kumbaga parang ito yung pinuhunan ng firm para makagawa siya ng goods and services. Okay? I-solve natin to. Example, yung letter A. 1,000 times 300. Kasi per unit, ang halaga ng per unit ay 300. Halimbawa na lang, yung bottle of vitamin C. Okay? Yung isang bote ng vitamin C cost 300 pesos. Okay, 300 pesos per bottle. E nakapag-produce ka ng 1,000 bottles ng vitamin C. So let us assume na mabibili lahat yan. So 1,000 bottles times 300 pesos. So kikita ka ng 300,000 pesos. Eh ang nagastos mo, yung total cost, 50,000. So ibawas natin yun. Yung total revenue, ito, yung state of market, TR minus TC, total revenue minus total cost. So ang kinita mo, 250,000 pesos. So profit, kumita ka. Okay? Next, sa letter B tayo. The quantity, yung total cost, sabihin natin 1,420, yung quantity supply 100. Okay, i-multiply natin yung quantity supply na 100 times 300. Sabihin natin 300 pesos times 100 bottles of vitamin C. So, magkano kikitain yung total revenue? Sabihin natin 30,000 pesos, di ba? 30,000 pesos ang kikitain niyan, total revenue. However, meron total cost. Gumastos yung firm ng 1,420 sa pagpuproduce ng 100 bottles of vitamin C. So, i-minus natin yan. So, 30,000 pesos minus 1,420. So, anong sagot? 28,580. Diba? So, kumita siya ng 28,580. So, profit. Kumita. Profit. Okay, next. 300 pesos times 700 bottles of vitamin C. So, ilan yan? 210,000 ba? 210,000 pesos. So, kumita ka ng 210,000 pesos. Pero ang nagastos mo sa pagpuproduce ng 700 bottles of vitamin C ay 300,000 pesos. So, anong state of market? Negative? Mukhang negative nito. Negative 90,000 pesos. Di ba? So, lugi ka ng 90,000 pesos. Okay? So, loss. Okay? Next, letter D. 300 pesos times 210 bottles. So, ilan yan? So, total revenue, 63,000 pesos. So, 63,000 pesos, eh ang nagastos mo sa pagpuproduce, yung firm gumastos ng 63,000 pesos to produce the quantity supply na 210 bottles. So, again, ang total cost, 63,000 pesos din. Ang kinita mo, 63,000 pesos din. So, ibig sabihin, break even. Bawi lang. In Filipino, bawi. Bawi lang siya. Okay? Next, 300 pesos times 3,000 bottles of vitamin C. So, magkano yun? Magkano kikitain mo dyan? Na almost 900,000 pesos. Okay? Yun nga lang, ang total cost ng firm or ng company, gumastos siya ng 500,200 pesos para makapag-produce ng 3,000 bottles. Again, 3,000 bottles na i-produce niya. Okay? So, anong sagot? Almost 399,800. So, yan ang kinita nung firm or company. So, kumita siya ng 399,800. So, yun yung profit niya. Okay? So, again, pag sinabi natin revenue, it is the money generated from normal business operations calculated as the average sales price times the number of units sold. Okay? So, kapag nag-negative loss, ibig sabihin, nalugi, pagkalugi. Pag equal lang, break even. Or in Filipino, bawi lang. So, kapag nag-positive siya, ito, positive. Ibig sabihin, profit. Okay? So, profit. So, any question about the point of maximum profit, yung state of market, and different types of economic system. Itong